Hey guys, today I'm going to go over the Winsor Newton Pigment Markers, which are a new product from Winsor Newton, as well as test several papers to see how well they work for them. This is an augmentation of my blog, Natto Soup, which is www.nattosoup.blogspot.com. You can find the link below, and ideally there's an annotation here to help direct you. So first off, I'm going to show you guys the Winsor Newton pigment markers I have. As of right now, if you're ordering a set of six, like I have a set of six skin tones that I ordered pretty much as soon as I found out these markers were out from Dick Blick. You are, however, able to buy most of those colors open stock. And as you can see, I have a fair variety, minus the skin tones. I have the white pigment marker, which you guys have seen me, I'm sorry, the white blender, which you guys have seen me use on a couple of illustrations. I have the colorless blender, and I have a fair selection of colors. I would ideally wanting to hold off all of my tests until my skin tone set came in, but it kept getting pushed back and pushed back. It kind of ruined my review plans. So I'm going to do the best that I can, and rather than drawing Kara for you guys, I'm actually going to illustrate a bouquet because that takes advantage of the colors I do have. These markers are alcohol-based pigment markers, which I think makes them the first alcohol-based pigment markers, but they're also water-soluble, which makes it extremely difficult to find a pin you can use with these, or at least it's made it difficult for me to find a pin I can use with these on Yupo, which was the paper that was recommended to me by one of the Winsor & Newton reps at Hands-On Creativity at my local Plaza art supply store. Unfortunately, I can't go over Winsor Newton's marker paper in this video because I don't have it. The same way I can't go over the skin tones in this video because I don't have it. But I can go over several other papers that I have lying around and that you might have lying around. So I kind of did my best guesses what would work. So I have Strathmore Mixed Media Board 500 series, which has been kind of sitting around my apartment for a while. So this is a fine time to use it. I have a Copic PM pad, which in regards to Copic papers, I like because it's a little bit translucent, but it is not an it doesn't absorb the ink as well as other papers, which actually might work well for the pigment markers because one of the problems I've had with it in my sketchbook is that I can't get the colors to do anything other than just sit on top of each other. I have this cute little deleter sketchbook, which I got in Japan several years ago and I'd like to use. And it's got a heavier paper. It's kind of, it's like a thinner Bristol, kind of like a cardstock with a texture. I have 400 series mixed media paper. I have wood pulp based watercolor paper. I have marker board. I have some of this distressed watercolor cardstock, which I'm going to do other tests on it too. I have my suspicions about it, but I'm not going to spoil them here. I have Yupo, and as you can see, I've already tested several pens with the Yupo. I've done tests with the colorless blender as well as with just plain water. And like I said earlier, it's really difficult. I couldn't find anything that actually wouldn't smear with when you add the alcohol-based marker. The closest I came was the Maxon Pro Color 2. Oh, and this is giving the markers the pen ink 24 hours to cure, which you should do if you can. And I do it for all of my tests. I never apply color directly because it will smear. Even with that 24-hour dry time, the Maxon Pro Color 2 smeared. It didn't smear as badly, but it still makes me kind of hesitant to apply color on top of it, especially since the ink could ruin your nibs, and the nibs on the Winsor & Newton pigment markers are not replaceable, and they're not refillable. Crescent render paper, which is supposed to be a good paper for markers, and translucent Yupo, which I thought, since I can't find a pin that will work, what I'm probably going to have to do to render with pigment markers on Yupo is I'm probably going to have to use a light box, and I thought the translucent paper might, and composite everything together in Photoshop. And I thought the translucent Yupo might make that a little bit easier because I could just maybe slide the inks underneath and work directly. Some other papers that I'll probably end up testing but are not part of this video are Strathmore 500 series plate Bristol, which I often use for Copic markers and cardstock, another thing that I often use for Copic markers, and Winsor Newton's marker paper, which I don't have yet. So let's get started. So 400 series Strathmore multimedia paper, which is paper that should work with ink, it should work with markers, it should work with watercolor. There wasn't significant buckling, it's a little bit thicker. Next up is the crescent board. So actually the reds are a little bit darker, a little less gray, but there's a lot more paper pilling. Whereas there's no paper pilling on here. Canson Montvol watercolor paper, very gray, some paper pilling. The paper was pulling, like buckling. But you get a little bit of interesting color variation by what settles into the texture of the paper and what sits on top. Harder to blend. Sorry about the old lady noises. Copic PM paper. Kind of like middle of the road in terms of color saturation. Was easier to do details on. Harder to do large even fills on. Ink dried a little bit quicker. There is some paper pilling with successive layers, or like a scrub texture, which is very commonly used to apply color evenly with alcohol-based markers. Does not work with the pigment markers because it just kind of pushes the pigment buildup around. What are you? Okay. Crescent render paper. So this is the crescent marker board. This is the crescent render paper. I'd actually used some of the opaque white on the render paper, but it's coming up more as like a butter color than a white because it picks up that pigment. Paper pilling on the crescent paper. It's not as thick as the crescent board. Colors aren't as vibrant as the crescent board. This is the Tim Holtz Distress watercolor paper. I'm sorry, watercolor cardstock, which is a thin watercolor cardstock. It looks like, there's a texture on both sides, so it looks like it might have been mold made. It might actually be watercolor paper, just marketed not as watercolor paper, which I don't understand. Colors are a little more vibrant on this. Because there's more texture, the pigment can settle into the crevices, so you get more color variation. And lastly, Yupo, which in my opinion is the most vibrant, it's the most exciting, it's also the most difficult to work with, most difficult to control, very gestural, very loose. The colors don't soak into the paper, so you're seeing the white of the paper bouncing like through the colors, so they're brighter than they are on any of the other papers we've done. I'm sorry, it's more apparent in person than it is on camera, and I don't think it's necessarily the lighting, because I have a natural light lamp on one side and an LED lamp on the other, so the colors are pretty, my colors are pretty true in the studio. But anyway, I had the most fun painting on the Yupo paper, and it gives the most interesting effects, but I found these markers to be difficult to control, and I'm going to try some other things, but for now, that's this video. I'm holding off on giving an opinion on Winsor Newton pigment markers until the Winsor Newton pigment paper, the Winsor Newton marker paper comes in and my skin tone set comes in. I'm sorry, I'm holding you guys hostage. And I try inking and then coloring that. I mean, I'm going to really give these a fighting chance, because I think using a pigment and an alcohol marker that is also water soluble is a really interesting idea. And I want to see the kinks get worked out, because I want these to be a product that people have access to. if you guys have any suggestions, or if I've done something glaringly wrong and you know it, and you can tell me how to fix it, I would love to hear from you. If you have an art supply review blog that you'd like me to check out and promote, leave a comment or send me an email. I hope you guys have a good day. Bye.